In the previous session, we have just discussed about the voltage control of DC series generator. So I told you in this particular section, we'll start with the non-linear analysis of a separately excited DC series generator. Now this non-linear analysis is very similar to what you do in a DC motor. So therefore, this session will be a very small session. In the next session, let us do a numerical, which will take considerable amount of time. Alright, so let's begin. So you know that EA is a function of what? EA is a function of MMF, right? And this MMF is the one which produces the flux, right? It is the one which is produces the flux. Okay, so EA is a function of flux, and this flux is produced by the MMF. You know that MMF can vary with due to armature reaction. MMF can vary due to armature reaction, right? What is the effect? It is a flux weakening effect and the shifting of the magnetic neutral poles. So now let us take the flux reduction here. So the flux reduction. So what happens is that as the armature reactions increases, the flux weakening increases, right? The flux weakening increases. So if flux weakening increases, flux drops, and EA, which is equal to K phi omega, also drops, right? So this is a problem associated with the armature reaction. Now this reduction in flux, I have told you, we can quantify it by a particular value of current, right? So if, for example, 90 Weber is represented by, say, 2 amperes, right? So due to the armature reaction, if it reduces to 70 Weber, these are just values, all right? No practical significance, just to explain the thing. So corresponding to the 70 Weber, you can define another current, which is, let us say, IF star, right? So this reduction in the flux can be quantified. So this IF star can be some 1 ampere or 1.5 ampere, something like that. So the reduction in flux can be quantified by another current. Same thing I am repeating here, because people who are seeing this lecture for the first time, they should not feel confused. Another field current IF star. Alright. So now you know that the net MMF will be equal to the MMF in the poles minus the MMF due to the armature reaction, right? MMF due to the armature. So the net MMF will be due to this particular IF star. So if the number of field winding is NF, so NF into IF star, because MMF is equal to N into I, will be equal to MMF in the poles, actual MMF, which you expect. So NF into IF minus armature reaction, right? That means this IF star value will be equal to NF into IF divided by NF, all right, minus F of MMF of armature reaction divided by NF. Okay, that means IF star, you can solve it for that. So it will be NF minus armature reaction MMF divided by NF. So the same relation, what I have done is just I have repeated what I have done in the DC motor. Now, not only this, you know that the flux also actually affects the speed, right? Now, that was in case of the DC motor. Now, corresponding to this IF star, how can you find the value of induced EMF? I told you that you can find from the magnetization curve, right? So this is EA. Magnetization curve is between EA and IF, right? So it is something like this. It is something like this, right? Now, this can be the value of IF. Okay, so if this will be the value of IF star, because IF star corresponds to the reduced flux, so it will be less than this, right? Now, corresponding to this, you can find the value EA. Let me call it as EA0. Why it is called EA0 is because the magnetization curve is drawn for a particular speed, say omega naught, right? But the machine might be working in another speed. See, the magnetization curve might be drawn by the manufacturer, but you are making the machine work in some another speed. Now, that is depending on the manufacturer at what speed he has calculated the magnetization curve, but you might be working in a different speed. So based on that, how can you find the new correct value of armature induced EMF? or the correct value of speed depending upon the problem. So I can tell that EA0 corresponds to say N0, and you know that omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60. So I can use this relation directly. EA0 will correspond into the speed. Okay. And the EA, which is found using usually the KVL in the problems, will corresponding to the speed which is given to you, the speed in which it's actually working. That means I can substitute that N by N0 will be equal to EA by EA0, right? That means N is equal to EA divided by EA0 multiplied by N0. So this is the equation that we saw in DC motors as well, right? Now in DC motors, usually it was the, we had to find the value of N, speed. Well, DC motor, the output parameter is speed. So basically you usually find that in the numericals. But in the generator's case, mostly the problems numericals will be associated with the finding of the value of EA. Alright. So this is the basic relation. You can find N usually in sorry, I don't know why this keeps on coming up. Yeah. Usually in the numerical, they will give this particular value at what speed you are rotating the DC generator. And usually our task becomes finding the value of EA. So this is how you find it from the magnetization curve. So I hope you have liked today's particular session. In the next session, let us discuss a numerical on based on all these concepts till we have learned now. So if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe the channel. Let me tell you that there is a DC machinery fundamentals and DC motor playlist in the same channel. Other than that, there is also an engineering circuit analysis playlist which has been made quite time before. So you can check that also to understand basics on engineering circuit analysis. And with that, let me take your leave and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.